how the radius of the nucleus is estimated, write its relation to radius and atomic mass number. At Rutherford's suggestion, Geiger and Marson performed their experiment on the scattering of alpha particles from thin gold foil. Their experiments revealed that the actual size of the nucleus of gold has to be less than 4×10⁻⁴ meter. By performing scattering experiments in which fast neutrons instead of alpha particles are projectiles that bombarded target made up of various elements, the size of nuclei of various elements have been actually measured and got the following formula. A nucleus of mass number A. Nucleus of mass number A has the radius r is equal to r0 a raised to 1/3, where r0 is equal to 1.2×10⁻¹⁵ meter is equal to 1.2 Fermi, where 1 Fermi is equal to 10⁻⁵ meter. The value of the constant is in the order of the range of nuclear force, and the value of r0 depends on the type of projectile particle. Volume of the nucleus V is equal to 4/3 πr³ is equal to 4/3 πr² r0 a raised to 1/3 raised to 3 is equal to 4/3 πr³ × a. Therefore, V proportional to A, 4/3 πr³ is constant, and the density of the nucleus rho is equal to mass upon volume is equal to ma/4/3 πr³ a is equal to 3m/4πr³. Hence, density of the nucleus does not depend on the mass number A. The density of the substance of the nucleus rho is equal to 3m/4πr³ is equal to 3×1.66×10⁻²⁷ divided by 4×3.14×1.2×10⁻⁵ whole cube. Therefore, rho is equal to 0.22945×10⁻¹⁸. Rho is equal to 2.3×10⁻¹⁷ kilogram per meter cube. Hence, density of nucleus is 2.3×10⁻¹⁴ times that of the density of the water 10⁻³ kilogram per meter cube. The density of the nucleus is very large because the atom has a large amount of empty space. Write and explain the Einstein theory of special relativity. From theory of special relativity, it is necessary to treat mass as another form of energy. Before the theory of special relativity, it was presumed that mass and energy were conserved separately in a reaction. But Einstein showed that mass is another form of energy, and one can convert mass energy into other form of energy like kinetic energy and vice versa. This mass energy equivalent is related to E is equal to mc square, where m is mass, c is velocity of light in vacuum. Its value is equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second. Experimental verification of Einstein mass energy relation has achieved in the study of nuclear reactions among nucleons, nuclei, electrons, and other more recently discovered particles. In the reaction, the conservation of law of energy state that the initial energy and final energy are equal. This concept is important in understanding nuclear masses and the interaction of nuclei with one another. Derive the formula for binding of a nucleus by explaining the mass defect of the nucleus, and write the formula explaining the binding energy per nucleon. The nucleus is made of neutrons and protons. Therefore, it may be expected that the mass of the nucleus is equal to the total mass of its individual proton and neutrons. But the nuclear mass m is found to be always less than its constituent neutrons and protons in the free state. Suppose if the mass of the nucleus ZXA is capital M, we indicate the masses of the proton and neutrons in the free state as MP and MN. Then always, that is capital M is less than ZMP plus NMP, where N is equal to Z minus A, neutrons, neutron number. The difference between the total mass of the constituent of the nucleus and the mass of the nucleus is called mass defect. Delta M is equal to ZMP plus A minus Z NMN minus capital M is a formula of mass defect. From Einstein's mass energy equivalence, the equivalent energy delta mc square is emitted to mass defect delta m, where c is the velocity of light in vacuum. That is, by combining z proton and n neutrons, nucleus which is formed reduced by mass delta m and energy is equal to delta mc square, energy will be released. On the contrary, if we separate a nucleus of mass capital M into Z proton and N neutrons, we should have to supply a total energy equal to energy EB to those particles. This energy is called binding energy of nucleus. Binding energy EB is equal to delta MC square, C is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. By combining certain number of neutrons and protons, the nucleus having charge and mass is formed. Then the energy EB will be released in that process. This energy is called binding energy of nucleus. By dividing the binding energy of the nucleus by the number of nucleons, the binding energy EBN per nucleons is obtained. Here, binding energy per nucleons EBN is equal to EB upon A. The binding energy per nucleons is measure of stability of the nucleus. Binding energy per nucleons as the average energy per nucleus needed to separate a nucleus into its individual nucleons. Draw the nature of graph of average binding energy per nucleons against atomic mass number and explain its notable points. The binding energy per nucleons versus the atomic mass number A graph is shown in figure. Just you can see in figure also, mass number A and binding energy per nucleons, mega electron volt, 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, and here it is given 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. The following are the main features of the plot. The binding energy per nucleons EB is practically constant, that is perfect, practically independent of the atomic number of nuclei of middle mass number, that is 30 less than A less than 170. The value of the maximum binding energy EBN per nucleons is 8.75 mega electron volt per nucleons. It is for the iron Fe atom is equal to 56. The value of EBN for atomic mass number is equal to 238 is 7.6 mega electron volt per nucleons. EBN is lower for both light nuclei A less than 30 and heavy nuclei A greater than 170. From this graph, it can be said that binding energy per nucleons of nucleus of 1H2 is lowest and for iron Fe is it is highest. The ratio of neutrons and protons is required to be 1:1 for the stability of the light nucleus, whereas for heavy nucleus this ratio increases to 3:2. Write and derive the law of radioactivity decay. In any radioactive sample which undergoes alpha, beta and gamma decay, it is found that the number of nuclei undergoing the decay per unit time is proportional to the total number of nuclei in the sample. If capital N be the number of nuclei in the sample and delta N undergoes decay in time delta T, then delta N upon delta T proportional to capital N. The number of delta N of decaying nucleus is always positive. Delta N upon delta T is equal to lambda into capital N, where lambda is called decay constant or disintegration constant. If the period delta T corresponds to 0, then limit delta T tends to 0, delta N upon delta T is equal to minus lambda N. Minus dN upon dt is equal to lambda N number 1, where dN is the change in capital N, where which may be positive or negative. Hence it is negative because of time goes by, the number of nuclei remaining will decreases. Writing the equation 1 as follow: dN upon N is equal to minus lambda dt, integrating on both the side, N 0 to N integration, dN upon N is equal to minus lambda integration, that is T is equal to 0 to T dt. At time T is equal to 0, the number of undisintegrated nuclei of radioactive element is N 0, and at the time T is equal to T, it is capital N. Integration of N 0 to N dN upon N is ln N, N 0 to N is equal to minus lambda into T, 0 to T limits. Therefore ln N minus ln N 0 is equal to minus lambda T minus 0, ln log N upon N 0 is equal to minus lambda T. Therefore N upon N 0 is equal to e raised to minus lambda T, N is equal to N 0 e raised to minus lambda T.